Yeah, good morning, every one of you.
Morning, sir.
Hi, good morning. We were
Good
seeing
morning,
this
sir.
one. Hi, good morning. We were seeing this one, multi-stage cross-current operation. So I just want to quickly revise this one and then we will try to solve the problem based on this one. So this will be cross-current flow because only the one stream is going to affect the next stage in the concurrent cross-current operation. But the other stream, which may be raffinate stream or a solvent stream, is not going to affect this one. In every stage, a fresh solvent stream will be just coming into contact with the feed, which is passing from stage to stage. So this is a cross-current operation. So in the first stage, feed is entering. For the next stage, the feed is nothing but the extract which is obtained from the first stage. This is about the cross-current operation. So we have seen the material balance for stage 1 to stage NP. So for example, for stage 1, we have already derived this one. So for stage 1, the inputs, two inputs are F plus R01 or R0, we can simply say R01 is equal to two outputs, E1 plus R1. So that is equal to some mixed stream M1. Then similarly, the solute balance, this is solution balance, F means A plus C. Then solute balance means only C. So F into YF, why? Because this is mole fraction on B fray basis of C in feed stream. YF into R0 into X0, this one, we can say R0, X0, one we can also say. Then output is E1 into Y1 plus R1 into X1. Is equal to some mixed stream M1 to this with a mole fraction of a component C is YM1. So M1 into YM1, this one. Then if you just interchange the variables, just equate these two. So YM1 is equal to F into YF plus R0 into X0 divided by M will be coming in the denominator. So this is YM1. So this M1 can be anything depending on the given data in the problem. If they are giving the inputs, this is known. We can keep this M1 instead of this M1, we can keep F plus R0. If this is also known in some prior type of problems in the staged evaluation process, what happens, this is also will be known. So E1 plus R1, M1 we can put E1 plus R1. Then my material, by material balance or by definition, we can say NM1 is nothing but the mole fraction. What we say, this mole ratio of B in the stream, in M1 stream. So M1 stream, this mixed stream. So NM1 is equal to B by M1. Why? Because B by, this is N1. Okay, M1 only, yeah. B by M1. Okay, B by, so M1 is equal. For understanding, I have given for NP stages or final stage, we have to calculate. For all the stages, we have to calculate the material balance. So similarly, if you know the material balance for stage 1, stage 2, you can conduct, stage 3, you can conduct. And for NP stages, so we can conduct the material balance. If you see the NP stage, the same one, if you verify the streams here also 4 streams are there. But the input stream or a feed stream for this NP stage is from the previous stage, that is NP-1. So ENP-1, which is coming from the previous stage compared to this NP, is ENP-1, ENP-1 plus R0, which is a fresh stream, fresh solvent stream, which is entering inside this one. ENP-1 plus R0NP is equal to two output streams. One is ENP plus RNP, which is equal to some mixed stream, MNP. Then similarly, the solute balance or C balance, this is FR0 means A plus C balance, solution balance, first equation. The next equation is solute C balance. So ENP-1 into YNP-1 plus R0NP into X0NP is equal to ENP into YNP plus RNP into XNP. In a similar way as we derived in the equation stage 1, the same process will be applied here. So YNP, this two will be equated. The first, this one and this one will be equated. Then YNP, YMNP is equal to this. We can equate this one. Instead of M1, instead of MP, we can write this one or this one based on our requirement. So this one, Then MNP, similar, in a similar fashion, NM1, we can define for the MPth plate, NPth plate. So B by MNP, this MNP can be this one or this one, depending on our requirement. So the step-by-step procedure. In the step-by-step procedure, last time I have just drawn in the OneNote, I have shown this one. Once again, I will explain how to obtain this number of stages, or we can obtain the E1 and E2 strings. So the problem here is they will give at least the output values E1 and R1, or even or ENP or RNP, or for example, for stage one, E1 and R1 they have to give, or for nth stage or overall stage, they have to give ENP or RNP. Yes. What happens? Anytime the stream concentration or the stream values ENP and RNP also we have to find. For that to find, we have to draw the graphical. We have to go for the graphical procedure. First, if you want to find something, they have to provide us the data. Otherwise, some equation they have to provide. So the relationship between X and Y or relationship between N, X, Y. Depending on that relation, one thing is we can calculate the tabular values, or otherwise in a tabular form, they have to provide the X, Y values as well as N value. So then in a single graph paper, you can divide the graph paper into two halves. One is for N versus XY and X versus Y. Similarly, as we done in the stage single stage operation. Then next you have to do is distribution curve. You will draw X versus Y and N versus Y you will draw. And next one is if X is N is not dependent on this X, then what happens? This X axis, whatever is there, that will fall as N versus X. Usually for your syllabus, it will be like this only, N versus X will be this only, because N is equal to zero in R stream or a solvent stream or the overflow, that N is equal to zero. Because of this, this will every value will come on the only on the X axis. Then next one you have to do is first you have to identify the point F. So what is this point F? F is nothing but with a coordinate system. So YF they will get an NF. C values. So from C values we can found, because YF is nothing but this C by A plus C. NF is nothing but B by A plus C. So with that one we can find this coordinate system. Then NF is on Y axis and YF is on X axis. You can locate the same that point somewhere here. Then after locating this one, the next point you have to fix is this R0. R0 is at X0 into X0, N0, whose coordinate is X0 and N0 for R0. So X0 obviously something will be there. If pure solvent, that X0 will also be 0, because X0 is equal to C0, C by A plus C. C is equal to 0 means X0 is equal to 0. And N0 is equal to nothing but B by A plus C. Then B is equal to 0. If it is pure solvent, B is also 0, C is also 0. Only present is A. So R0 is equal to whose coordinate system is N0, X0. So using that N0, X0, we can locate our point R0. Then you have to join this F R0 with a straight line. These two points, when you join this, it will be F R0 line. Then after joining these two lines, so this line is the basis for our calculation. The next one is you have to find what is E1 and X1. So how to find that E1 and X1? Depending on the tie line. Okay, depending on the tie line, we have to find. Then what is the basis for this timeline? Basis for this timeline is this M1, so mixed stream. So how can we find this M1? So this M1 can be found using these two equations. So M1 is nothing but the coordinate system whose values are YM1 and NM1. So these two equations can be used to find M1 value or a mixed stream value. That point you have to locate here. It will definitely fall on this line only, F and R0 line only. Then after locating this M1, then what happens? You have to draw a tie line based on this M1 point. So how to draw this tie line? The best one is to guess for the trial and error method. So trial and error method, based on the values of this X axis, you have to guess any one value. Then you have to project this value until the equilibrium or a distribution curve. Then once again, the horizontal line you have to draw up to that same line. You have to project up to the diagonal line or a 45 degrees diagonal line. And after that, you have to then once again upward, towards upward, horizontal vertical line. You have to project this same point from the diagonal to the N versus Y curve. If the first point, if you have guessed at this point, that is matching with this point, okay, with the last point on the tie line, and that last point and this first point, which when you just connect these two points, that point is falling at this M1 point, then only this tie line is correct. So otherwise, you have to assume once again the same x value and project the same procedure. You have to repeat until and unless you are joining two nodal points, the first starting initial point and the next final point, which is on the N versus Y curve. If you both first point and last point, if you join this one, if they are falling in the M1 only, then you can believe that that is your true tie line. Then from this tie line, we can estimate the what is the value of y. This is value of y when this point is projected up to the y, up to the y axis. Then if this on the x axis, this is E and R in the raffinate and extract streams. So from that one, based on the material balance equations, we can estimate whatever the required parameters from these two values. Then this point will be called as a E1 point, at which the last point which touches as N versus Y, and R1 at which it will be touching at N versus Y axis. So these are E1 and this is R1. Then after that, what you have to do, the same point where the E1 is there, that point you have to once again connect to the point R0. So this is important. So E1 and R0, you have to connect this one. After connecting this one, once again, you have to estimate the coordinate system for M2. M2 is nothing but when M1 is NM1 comma YM1, then M2 will be NM2 YM2. Thank you, sir. NM2 and
M2, sir.
How to calculate?
NM2, sir. For we should have NM2. B2, no, sir.
B2, that's what, na? Inert means what? It is going to remain same throughout the process. That's the advantage of this.
B is same.
So in cross current, if you see, for our ideal stage, what happens? All the B is only E or A. Solids are going to be in all the stages up to the NP stages. So B value, what is remaining in the feed stage, that value will be same in every stream. Okay, that's the definition of inert. Is it okay, Ravi?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then that one, so NM1. Now for the stage 2, we have to calculate. So that M2 value will be calculated using this one, YM2 and NM2. When YM2 and NM2 means the next stage material balance you have to apply. For next stage, this E1 plus R0-2 will be your feed for the next stage, this stage. So E1 plus R0 is equal to E2 plus R2. Similarly, for the solute, E1 into Y1 plus R0 into X0 is equal to E2 into Y2 plus R2 into X2 is equal to M2 into YM2. So that YM2 you can calculate using the material balance equation, and NM2 is defined as B by, since B is constant throughout the process, so we can define that NM2 is equal to B by M2. So that is B by M2. Once again, today I forgot my this tab, writing tab. So I asked William sir to bring this for me. Yeah. One second, I will connect this tab. Okay, then NM2, M2 point is nothing but YM2, comma NM2. That coordinate system will be there. So that point you can locate on this line. So this is very important because M2 will lie on this E1 and R0 joining point, or a straight line of this E1 and R0. If that is not lying, means your calculation somewhat, you have done mistake in your calculation. That M2 point will be definitely going to lie on this straight line only. After locating this M2 point, same procedure. So you have to draw the tie line. So how to draw the tie line? Once again, you have to assume the value of this x-axis. Then from that one until the equilibrium curve you need to project, or a distribution curve you need to project, then that point will be taken until the 45 degrees diagonal line. Then after this, you vertically project this line up to n versus y axis. If you are connecting this initial guess, which you are n versus y axis, so that value is falling on this one. That straight line is falling on this M2 point. Then your tie line value is correct. Your tie line is correct. If not, you have to correct your guess value. So after that, where the nodal point are touching on the n versus y axis, that is called E2 point. And here, this is R2 point. So this E2 and R2 coordinates we already obtained. So how can we obtain? This is Y2 on the y axis, and this is on the x axis, X2. So X2 and Y2 we already obtained. So X2 and Y2, once we obtain this, using these material balance equations, we can find what is E1 and R1. Stream values of E1 and R1. Similarly, until the n stages, we can perform the same operation. For each and every stage, we can perform the same operation. Now, this is stage 1 and this is stage 2. Similarly, for np stages, we can carry out that same process. So, I hope you understood that one. So, let us see one problem based on this one. So, if anybody is having doubt, just ask me. So, beforehand, if you understand the single stage operation, then this is very easy. If you don't understand the single stage operation, so this is tough. Then if you don't understand this one, the next process, which is multi-stage countercurrent operation, that is very tough. So each and every stage you have to understand, then only you can solve the problems based on that previous procedural values. Here, not talent of yours is doesn't matter, but procedure. How can you remember that procedure is very much important, okay, compared to your talent. The mass transfer, nothing to do with our talent, only how can you remember, how can you conduct a material balance or a mass balance, that is very much important. So this one is So I will just read this problem. So the problem is, this is multi-stage cross current operation. So that material balance we already conducted. So this is soda is being of slake. So okay, caustic soda means NaOH is being made using this CaOH with a solution of sodium carbonate. So solution of sodium carbonate means plus H2O plus CaCO, NaCO3 will be there in this one, and using these two reactants, so they are making NaOH. So we have to write down that equation first, then the resulting slurry, okay, whatever the slurry is there by mixing these two, one consists of a particles of CaC, this calcium CaCO3 particles are there, which are left out. So this we can consider as inert solids, CaCO3, after forming from CaOH plus Na2CO3, sodium carbonate, suspended in a 10% NaOH. So this is 10% of NaOH means, now from this one, what is A, what is B, what is C, we have to just find out that one. That's an interesting one. So then this is 0.12 kg suspended solid per kg solution. So 0.125 kg suspended solid per kg means this is B value in the input stream or a feed stream. So this is settled. So after reaction, they are settling. So this is settled. The clear sodium hydroxide, so NaOH solution, withdrawn. So NaOH has been withdrawn, clear solution, and replaced by an equal weight of water. So whatever the clear solution, okay, in the this leaching operation, there are four streams. One is feed stream, next one is solvent stream, then third one is this one, clear solution stream, and fourth one is this underflow, or we can say that one, inert solid stream. So four streams are there. Now this is, they are giving, this is settled, the clear sodium hydroxide solution withdrawn. So R1, what is coming in the raffinate phase or the overflow phase, or we can say solution phase, the equal amount has been that same value R1 is equal to R0 or R1 is equal to the next stream value. So in the next stage, what they are doing, that solution, whatever the value of that solution is there, the same value, same amount after collecting this, giving to the sludge, okay? To the sludge, they are washing with water. Then, and the mixture thoroughly agitated. So mixtures are thoroughly agitating. So water plus that sludge, they are mixing. After repetition of this procedure, a total of 2 fresh water washes. So they are washing with water. Okay, how they are washing with water? Whatever the clear solution value, amount of clear solution is coming, those after collecting that clear solution, the same amount of water they are mixing once again. Water they are feeding to the next stage. So in a 2-stage fashion, they are operating. The first stage will be this one. What we call this reaction will be there. So reaction, we don't have any values for the reaction, because to calculate the reaction, we have to they have to give reaction rate or anything. So in the mass transfer, no reaction is involved. So you need not to worry about the reaction. But after conducting this reaction, what they are telling, in one stage they are settling. So settling will be one stage. So after settling, the clear solution they are obtaining, that same clear, the amount of clear solution what is there, it equivalent water they are washing in for the 2 stages. So first stage will be settling stage, and next stage will be 2 water washing stages are there. So what fraction of the original NaOH? So here you can identify that original NaOH. So from this one you can find, and this one also, this is settled, the clear sodium hydroxide solution. So we can assume this, we can clearly note from these 2 statements that C is NaOH here. So already they are telling somewhere the resulting slurry consists of particles they are saying. So this will be your B. Then the solution of sodium carbonate, this one solution means already water is there, plus here 2 water washes also they are giving here. So water washes means here water is your solvent, which is A. So C is NaOH, B is sodium, this sodium calcium carbonate, then this one H2O is your A. You can just find out that one. So what fraction of original NaOH in the slurry remains uncovered? So already in the whatever in the underflow, whatever sludge is there, in that sludge, how much amount of NaOH is already there? So that is not at all recovered in the solution stream. They are asking about that one, unrecovered NaOH percentage they are asking, or a weight fraction they are asking, and therefore lost in the sludge. Okay, in the extract stream, how much NaOH is already left, that they are asking. So the settling characteristics of the slurry determined under conditions representing the practice to be followed in the process shows adsorption of the solute on the solid. So this is not at all a required one for the statement they are giving like that. So X, so now we have to verify that X falls under our notation scheme or not. X is equal to weight fraction of NaOH in the clear solution. Yes, this is according to that one, C by A plus C, clear solution. Then this is N is equal to kg CaCO3. From this also you can identify this CaCO3 is nothing but your B value, because N is equal to B by A plus C. So kg CaCO3 means kgB by kg solution means A plus C. kgB by kc A plus C is settled strut, in settled strut. So this values they are given. Then Y value is nothing but in the extract phase, weight fraction NaOH in solution in the settled strut. So in the extract phase, this is the composition of NaOH or C by A plus C. This is also C by A plus C, and this is B by A plus C. So these are the values and are the given data they have given. So is that okay? You understand this problem?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, understanding this is very important. Then you can easily solve. Already we have every formula, you have every procedure here. So first thing is you have to write a given data. So here the process, in a statement way they are giving the process. So first process, what they are just telling, that caustic soda they are preparing, using the two reactants, which is CaOH twice plus sodium carbonate. So sodium carbonate is Na2CO3, gives rise to 2NaOH plus CaCO3. You can balance this equation. This need not to write this type of equations also. It is unnecessary, but to find out that what is there in your streams, you have to write this one. NaOH is very important because that is C, and this is CaCO3, which is B. Okay, from that statement only, we have to identify what is A, what is B, and what is C. So Na2CO3 is a solution, they are saying. With a solution means Na2CO3 is dissolved in water. So water is also there. From that also we can identify. And one more statement they are giving, fresh water washes also they are giving. The solvent here is your water. So from the process itself, okay, after this reaction, what is going to happen is this one. So this is stage one. In stage one, you can consider this is settling, or a mixer settler like thing we can tell, or settling tank we can say. So this is stage one, so which is nothing but a settling. So the feed you are giving inside this one, so feed is nothing but YF. Then for this one, some solvent may be giving, but here there is no solvent. Since this is a settling tank, only after settling a clear solution they are taking. So this you can consider some R0 one. So R0 one is zero, because not at all, we are not at all giving any solvent to this one. Okay, in the reaction they are giving this solution of Na2CO3 plus water, but here in the settling tank they are not giving. For the convenience, I am once again showing this stream will be connected to some reactor. Inside that reactor they are giving this two CaOH twice plus Na2CO3. So until this one, it is not our business to conduct a material balance or a reaction balance or a material balance for this operation. So after this process only we have to conduct the material balance. So after this reaction process only settling is going to happen. Inside this settling we are not any supplying any type of solvent. Only we are waiting until the settling conditions are satisfied and a clear solution can be obtained. So here X0 one will be there, so it is also zero because there is no supply of the other stream. Only we are allowing a feed stream and just waiting to just separate that stream. So a clear solution stream or a overflow stream will be obtained. That is raffinate stream or R1 X1. So this is coming out. After that one, a 10% solution. So initially the C will be 10%, depending on the basis what we are taking. If we take basis 100 kg of a solution, means the 10 kg will be this C composition, this C value, NaOH value, or we are taking 1 kg as a basis, means 10% means 0.1 kg of this NaOH will be there. Like that, depending on the basis, we can assume, because it is given in percentage. But only the process now we can understand simply. So after coming this one, so this is passing two-stage washing with a fresh water using this statement. Two fresh water washes. So water is a solvent which is going, this is stage two, and this will have four streams. So the stream which is coming from here is nothing but raffinate extract stream E1, Y1. Okay, whose composition of solute will be Y1. Then this is falling as an input to the stage two, which is a water wash stream. So then we're using a fresh water, they are washing this one. So this one will be R0 two. What is the R0 two value? Here they have clearly given the R0 two value somewhere. So this is settled, the clear sodium hydroxide solution withdrawn and replaced by an equal weight of water. So the solution which is obtaining from the stage one is clear solution, this one. So this one will be with equivalent amount of water, means this is R1. R0 two is equal to R1. Okay, is it okay? From that statement, the two stages, this one, equivalent amount of water, equivalent weight of water, they are replacing. If R1 is 1 kg, this R0 one will be 1. If this R1 is 2 kg, so this one will be 2 kg or not 2, or a solvent stream or a water stream, you can say. Then after that, what happens here? A clear solution, once again, it will obtain, that is R2, and with a composition of solute is X2. Then after that, one more stage is there, two water wash stages they are telling. So this one water, once again, water is going. So how much amount of water is going? Now R03 is equal to this one, clear solution, this is R2. From this statement itself, we can identify that one. So the stream which is coming, once again, is a clear stream, clear solution stream, which is R3, X3, since this is third stage. And the sludge stream which is coming is E3, Y3. So here, sorry, I forgot. So E2, Y2. So after coming out, what they are asking now, this is a sludge stream or inert solid stream. Inside this one, what is the value of C they are asking? So how much this is left behind in a weight fraction? So this one Y3, or we can say into 100. Okay, that how much C already left, how much NaOH is there in these solids which are contained in E3. So this is overall process which is going to take place here. Is this okay, this explanation? Now, if you understand the process, it will be very easy.
Sir.
Yeah. Pavani, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, is very it okay? Are you in confusion somewhat?
No, understand.
Yes, I can't understand your words. Voice is breaking. Okay, then this is the overall process which is going to happen. Now we have to assume the take the basis. So depending on this basis only, that percentage will be converted into some definite value. So basis, we can take 1 kg. 1 kg of solution in the original mixture. Okay, 1 kg of solution in the original mixture. So 1 kg is that value of F. So we can take in the solution means, already we can assume that is A plus C only we are assuming. So in this original mixture means already they have given 10% is this NaOH, or C is 10%. So original solution in which 0.1 kg will be your C value. C value is nothing but NaOH. And what about the remaining 0.9 kg? So 0.9 kg will be in the solution. Solution means A plus water. C. Water. This one A is water we can take. Now the in the input stream B is equal to, already they have given suspended solids. So this is 0.125 kg B by kg solution we can take. Solution means B by A plus C we can take this one. So this is the basis 1 kg. After assuming the basis 1 kg, we can just obtain the values 0.1 kg or 0.9 kg. Or when you assume this is some 100 kg or 10 kg, depending on this, we have to take these values. Now, the process is there. Yeah. Okay. Now the process is, first we have to conduct a balance. Okay, how we can conduct the balance? The first step in conducting balance is solution. Solution means first thing come up to your mind is A plus C. Solution balance for stage one. Yeah, solution balance for stage one. This solution means nothing but this one A plus C. So how can we conduct a solution balance for this one? So this is F, okay, this is solution balance. F plus input this one, F plus this R0 1 is the one input for the stage one. R0 1 is equal to two outputs, which is E1 and R1. So this will be E1 plus R1. So this one we can take equation one. Then solute balance. Solute means first thing come up to your mind is C balance, first stage one. So I'm writing as a common, this one is stage one. So this is F into YF plus R01 into X01 is equal to E1 plus R1. Since in the initial stage, we are taking this as M1 and this will be M1 into Y. So this one, this will be equation two. Already from these equations, from our problem statements, this R01 is equal to zero. X01 is also zero. So this one. So now, if you see this equation, so YM1, you have to equate this one with this one. So YM1 is equal to F into YF divided by this one is M1. So M1 from this equation one is F into YF divided by F from this equation. M1 is equal to this F only because R01 is already zero. So F is equal to F. So your YM1 is also equal to this YF from this statement. So YM1 value is equal to YF. YF already given there are 0.1% or 1% something they have given. So 0.1 that we can take. Otherwise, from C is equal to 0.1 kg divided by. So this YF is nothing but C by A plus C. C is equal to 0.1 kg. And solution is 1 kg basis we already taken. So this is equal to 0.1 only. In that way also you can calculate from the problem statement also it is 0.1 only. Okay, basis is very important. Depending on that basis only, everything is going to happen. So this one, then next one, by definition, what is NM1? NM1 is equal to B by M1. So B is, they already given, which is 0.125 divided by M1 is equal to this one. F into, okay, only F I guess. Okay, yeah, M is equal to this already zero and this is only F. So this is F only. So 0.125 divided by F value is 1 only. So this is also 0.125 kg B by kg A plus C. Okay, like this we can obtain the values. Is this okay until now? How we calculated that one? Now we already got our points like M1. What is the coordinate system for M1? M1 is equal to NM1, comma YM1. Then next coordinate system is point F we have to locate. Where is F? This is YF, comma NF. And next coordinate system is R0 point we have to locate according to the procedure, which is R0 is at X0, comma N0, whose coordinate system is X0 and N0. So whether these points are available with us or not, we can check this one. M1, already that point is available. This NM1 is this one 0.125, comma, this YM1 is 0.1. So M1 point can be located on this line. This is on Y axis, this is on X axis. So F point. So YF is already we know that is 0.1. So this is on X axis and this will be on Y axis. Y axis is NF. What is NF? NF is also 0.125 only. So this is on X is, NF. Then R0 point, where is that R0 point? X0 is zero, N0 is also zero. So these are the coordinate systems. So this is on X, this is on Y. So this is the coordinate system on which we are going to draw this graph. Based on this, we are going to draw the graph. in the single physical graph paper we can do in a single graph itself. So these are very limited blocks are there. Because of that, I'm taking this one. So you can draw N versus Y. You can use the above graph for N versus X comma Y. And the below graph, you can use X versus Y graph. So N versus Y, the data you have to. Okay, now I already drawn in the physical paper, so you can just draw on your own this one. Now N versus X graph, so these values we have to use N versus Y, and N versus X is obviously going to fall in this angle only, this X axis only, so N versus Y. So N values, if you see, it is varying from 0.495 to 0.666. So you can take from 0, you can start. So 0.1 you can take. Okay, like this, you can take 0.2, some 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, some 0.7, 0.8, 0.9. Like this, you can take. Then the next one is this, since these are the x-axis, so up to 1 only will be there. Okay, it is 0.0900 it is there. So up to 0.01 only, 0.1 only, the maximum value. So all the points are up to 2 digits, up to 2 digits it is there. So x and y also same, 0.01, 0.01, 0.09, okay, 0.09, this is also 0.09. So you can take this also point from 0 you can start, but up to 2 digits are there. So 0.01 we can take. This is 0.02, 0.03, 0.04, 0.05, 0.06, 0.07, 0.09, 0.1. Okay, like this you can take 0.11. 0.12, but 0.1 is maximum, 0.09 is there, 0.1 is maximum. So like this you can fix. Then you can draw N versus, first this one, N versus Y values. So N is equal to 0.495. 0.49 means this one, 0.49, and Y is 0.09. Okay, 0.09. Okay, this one, 0.49, 0.090. So this point will be this one of them. Yeah, this point will be this one. Next point is .07 is this one. 6 means this one, 0.076 and 0.525. 0.5, 0.5, 0.52 means this one. Somewhere here it will come. Then the next point is this one and this one. So 0.0608 means 0.0608 also we can take. Yes, 6.6 we can take. Then 0.568 we can take. So 0.56 will be this one. This is one point. Then next point is 0.6 and 0.0452. 0.6, okay, this is 0.6 and 0.0. Somewhere I missed 1, 2, 3. 0.6 and 0.0452. 0.045 is this one and 0.6 is this one. Then the next point is this one, 0.620 and 0.0295. 0.620 is this one, 0.62. This one is coming. Then 0.02, 0.029, okay. 0.029, 0.62 will be coming somewhat here. This one. Then the next point is 0.65, 0.02. 0.65 is this one, 0.02. 65 and 0.02 will be this one. The next one is 0.659 and 0.014. 0.014 will be this one. Then 0.659, or means 656. So it will be coming somewhat here. The next one is this one, 0.66 and 0.0 coming here. Same point. Okay, this one, now we have to connect this accurately. Like this. Now this will be called as N versus Y, and this itself is N versus X. If you want, taking N is equal to 0, you can put these points X values, otherwise you cannot, you can leave like that, no problem in that one. Okay. Then you have drawn this one. The next step is you have to draw X versus Y versus X. So here. So this axis will be same as this axis here. So you have to take in such a way. So this one will be starting from 0 and 01, 02. 03, 04, 06, 07, 08, 09, 0.1, 0.11, 0.12, like this you can connect. And the next one is this one also will be same, because in the square it has to come, this one equilibrium graph or a distribution curve, it is usually square, then only that will be called as 45 degrees diagonal. With a blind move we can draw the 45 degrees diagonal. So 0.01 0.02 0.03 0.04 0.05 0.06 0.07 0.08 0.09 0.1. So the maximum values are this one only, 0.9. we can take 0.1 and 0.1 as our distribution, or a 45 degrees diagonal we can see. So this is Y values, these are X. This we are taking 0.1 and 0.1. So this is 45 degrees diagonal line. So after drawing this 45 degrees diagonal line, what we have to do? Distribution curve we have to draw. Distribution curve is nothing but this Y versus X. X values are this one, 0.9, and Y is 0.917. X is 0.9 means this one, 0.09, and 0.091 917 or 92, we can take that one. So this one is like this, it is going to fall somewhere here. Okay, this one. Then the next value is this one, 0.7 on x-axis and 0.762 on the y-axis. 0.07 and 0.076. So this one will be 0.076, second point. And the third point is on x-axis 0.0473. 0.047 means this one. Then 0.608. 0.068. Okay. 0.06. So this one. Then the next one is this one. 0.0333. Okay. 33 and 0.452. 0452. 0452 means this one. Then the next point, this one, 0.02 that one, 0.2095. Okay. This one, the next point is 0.02. This one coming like this. Then next point is this one 0.007. So 0007 will be coming here. 0007 and 0.014. Then 0.004, okay, 0.004 will be here and 0.01. So this will be like this. Then you have to connect your lines, this graphs. This one will be like this.
Let's see in the next class. Sir.
Okay. Yes. Yeah. Okay. 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 Until here, just once again revise and come.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Okay.